Good afternoon. My presentation is on PCO ring, a novel device to prevent posterior capsule opacity and enhance toricoevoid stability. No financial interest. If you have to introduce about cataract surgery, you have to go back by 2000 years where Susruta was one of the first to do the Cochin techniques. And after that, in the past 100 years, there has been a lot of evolution highlighting two landmarks, that is Ridley's lens and Kelman's phaco emulsification. And then we moved on from the monofocal lenses to trifocal lenses, which gives all three ranges of the vision. But there is this one factor which prevents the cataract surgery to reach its zenith, that is the posterior capsular opacity. Even after the advent of hydrophobic materials, square edge dye oils, rigorous PC polishing, we are still stuck at 12% of incidence. So our idea was to get rid of this 12%. And this 12% needs a capsulotomy, which eventually may lead to retinal detachments and cystoid macular edemas. So our idea was to develop a device which is innovative, inexpensive, simple in its concept, which can totally eliminate this PCO. Coming to the pathology, once the IOL has been implanted, the epithelial cells, they proliferate onto the equator and they go pass onto the posterior capsule, resulting in the posterior capsular opacity. So our basic idea here was to develop a device which acts as a robust barrier to prevent epithelial cell migration and which can completely eliminate the space between the posterior capsule and the optic so that there is no space for proliferation. So there is no space, no cells. So this is the device we developed, that is hydrophobic with 6.5 mm inner diameter and 9 mm outer diameter, which is 0.4 mm thickness with 4 dial holes. So this is a small animation showing how it actually works. So that is the PCO ring I was been talking about, and it can just be loaded like any other intraocular lens. So you can see that being loaded into the cartridge. Now here we can see the IOL has been already implanted inside the bag. Now as we inject the PCO ring, it unfolds and it does two things here. Here we can see the gap between the optic and posterior capsule. As the PCO ring unfolds, it pushes the optic against the posterior capsule, thus eliminating the space. So there is no space and no cells. And the second thing it does is, as it unfolds, it snugly sits in front of the equator, covering the range between 6.5 mm to 9 mm. That is where the most of the active anterior epithelial cells are present. So it totally blocks the migration. And this is one of the intraop pictures. Here we can see the three-piece IOL has been already implanted. Now this is the PCO ring I have been talking about, which has 4 dial holes with inner 6.5 mm and outer 9 mm of diameter. You can see it is being loaded into the cartridge. Since it is made up of hydrophobic material, it does give us some time to unfold, and meanwhile you can use the dial holes and slowly push it inside the bag. So as we push it in and we have to concentrically arrange it around the optic. And it is very easy and it is repeatable and it is very safe also. Here we are deliberately forming the AC so tight so that we can show the correlation between the optic and the PCO ring. Here we can see how they are sitting concentrically to each other, and it leaves a 0.5 mm of gap in between the optic and the PCO ring. And see, this is one of the pictures 3 years post-op where we can see a crystal clear PCO, and we can see the bunch of epithelial cells that are struck, and PCO ring acts as a barrier for it to pass. And this is OCT picture. This is the wavy thing we can see is the anterior highlight phase, and there is no gap between the optic and the posterior capsule here, and this is the edge of the PCO ring, and you can see how it is stuck to the anterior capsule. We have been getting very good results. But we want to prove it statistically, so we enrolled 50 patients with bilateral NS2 great cataract. Both eyes phaco emulsification was done 1 week apart by the same surgeon, and one eye was implanted with PCO ring and the other without PCO ring. At 3 years post-op, only 11 eyes without the PCO ring, 11 eyes without PCO ring developed PCO, and our threshold to consider PCO was very low. Even if we see one single epithelial cells in a Venn dilated pupil, we thought it as PCO. And only one eye with PCO ring developed PCO. And since it is made up of hydrophobic material, we thought it might enhance the toricoevoid stability also. Here, it has been aligned, and we can see once the PC O-ring is implanted, even when the surgeon tries to rotate the lens, it doesn't rotate, it just snugs back into the position. And we did similar study with the toric level also, and the rotation was as less as 2 degrees, which was evaluated 15 days and 30 days post-op. To conclude, PC O-ring is a simple and cost-effective device. It gives superior outcomes in premium IOLs, and it's definitely a boon in high-risk cases of retinal detachments, one-eyes, and high myopes, where YAG cap should be totally avoided. Thank you.
I have a few, quite a few questions actually. Good work, congratulations.
You
did review the literature to tell us a lot about cataract surgery. You have not told reviewed the literature specifically for PCO preventing devices. You didn't mention anything about
that. Yes, I didn't mention
this. That's relevant to the study.
Yes.
We don't want to have review of cataract because there are a lot of devices which have come in and gone about PCO prevention.
Yes.
And you should have told us how they were deficient and what problems they could not solve, which you have solved over here.
Yes.
That would have been more meaningful. So that now the bag we know has a variable size.
Yes, sir.
So how does this work? The bag diameter, thickness, everything is variable. You're trying, the principle you're saying is that it pushes the lens against the posterior capsule.
Yes, sir.
So it's a snug fit.
Yes.
And their cells are not able to migrate. So if the bag itself is going to be so variable in size, how can a one-size-fits-all ring work?
Yeah, it doesn't work for all cases. High myopes, you have to plan for a thicker and a bigger ring. The one case we had PCO, it was a high myope. So this problem we didn't anticipate before when we were studying. So high myopes, it does need thicker and larger rings. And this ring, we made it based upon multiple OCTs. Like we got many scans from the Catalyst, which gives a right size.
I agree.
Based on that, we prepared this thickness and size and everything. Yeah, it doesn't fit for all cases.
Refractive status may not be the only guiding principle for the bag size that we know from various studies.
Yes.
So there could be huge disparity in the anterior segment, posterior segment, overall diameter. So that is a question probably you'll have to address as you go forward with this.
Yes.
Now, what were the ethical issues did you take?
Yeah, we got clearance from the ethical committee of the institute.
Did you get a patient's consent?
Yes,
for
sir,
each
definitely.
One of them?
Yes, yes.
Because
yes.
They were having an additional implant which they didn't ask for.
Yes, sir, we took the consent from them.
Yeah. What are the complications of the surgery?
We didn't get any complications as such, sir.
None of them?
No, sir.
Okay.
No decentrations, nothing.
No, while implanting? Because you're putting another another device in the bag. So I would expect there could be a possible complication.
No,
so
we didn't face anything.
Thank you.
I would just like to ask, what was the age group in your series?
It was 50 to 65 years, ma'am.